Hello everyone, this is your professor once again, Danny Araneta Cabulay on the course Accountancy Research. We are now in week number 6 and this is video lecture number 26. For this particular episode, we will be talking about data gathering techniques. Alam nyo, pag nag-gather tayo ng data para sa research, very important yung quality ng research data na makuha natin. Kasi pag hindi maganda yung quality ng data natin, sabi nga nila, garbage in, garbage out. Vital to any research undertaking is the quality of data collected and processed. There are numerous data gathering or data collection techniques. The choice of technique must be based on 3 things: reliability, practicability, and capability of addressing the research problem. Kailangan yung data na makukuha natin, masasagot niya yung ating SOP o yung ating research problem. Now, when we talk about reliability, what do we mean by this? Reliability refers to the degree of truthfulness of the respondents or the source, as well as verifiability of such data gathered. It may also refer to the credibility of the source or author of the article or the research output. Practicability, on the other hand, is a combination of speed in acquiring information, logistical cost, and accessibility to respondents and data sources. Sa reliability, ibig sabihin nito, yun bang ating makukuhang data ay maaasahan natin? Yan ba ay totoo? Baka naman yan ay kasinungalingan o mahirap nating mapatunayan. Hindi yan tatayo. Okay? Pangalawa, pag sinabi naman nating practicability, practical ba? Madali ba tayo makakakuha ng data? For example, gusto mong mag-survey ng 200 tao, madali mo ba siyang magagawa? Paano kung may deadline ka? Will you be able to finish the work within, let's say, 1 month? Okay? So, and then, baka naman masyadong magastos. Wala na sa budget. Okay? So, that's gonna be a problem. Okay? So, let us try to look at one example. For example, Kenny Rogers Roasters. Tumatangkilik ba kayo ng Kenny Rogers? Okay? A chain of casual dining restaurant designed their own customer survey form, no? At itong customer survey form nila, sila mismong gumawa, okay? So they can secure feedback from diners that will assess their satisfaction with the products and services of each outlet. Kasi marami silang outlet. So gusto nilang malaman kung satisfied ba yung mga customers or not. So nag-design sila ng sarili nilang form at yun ang fini-fill upan ng kanilang mga customers. Okay? So, now, let's look at the other type of data. Meron tayong tinatawag na primary data. Pag sinabi nating primary data, this refers to data emanating from the original work or efforts of the researcher. Kagaya ng example ko kanina, ang Kenny Rogers, sila mismo ang gumawa ng survey form nila. So, sila mismo ang nag-conduct. That is an example of primary data. The researcher is the originator of the data to be processed. It pertains to data that is collected and processed for the first time. Researchers may develop their own survey forms or survey questionnaires, conduct interviews, and other research activities that they have initiated on their own. Kaya kayo, kung gagawa kayo ng survey form ninyo, that is going to be original data. That is going to be, you want primary data. That's what it means, okay? Now, meron pang isang klase ng data na tinatawag natin na secondary data. What is secondary data? This refers to data coming from other researchers or sources in which several statistical operations have already been performed, hence called second-hand data. Meaning, pag may nakita kang report from a government website or isang technical report or financial statements na nakuha mo sa SEC, those are examples of second-hand data or secondary data. Na-process na siya. Pero pwede mo siyang gamitin for research. Okay? Kasi maganda naman yon, maganda yung data na yun. Kumpleto na siya, na-analyze na. Ngayon, gagawan mo na lang ng bagong twist, okay? Gagawan mo na siya ng bagong level ng analysis, okay? Secondary data is also good to use. Hindi po kasi secondary data hindi na magandang gamitin, okay? Depende sa purpose ng research mo. Depende dun sa topic mo, okay? Secondary data is collected from various sources like publications, internal records of companies, census data, okay? Dun sa ating Philippine Statistics Authority, okay? Books, research journals, websites, and other studies, okay? Let's look at an example. A consulting firm was engaged to do an industry report on the oil and gas industry, would most likely rely heavily on data that is already available within public domain. Kaya dun sa inyo na mga gumagawa kayo ng mga industry report, most likely ang gagamitin nyo talagang data ay secondary data. Hindi nyo na kailangan mag-interview o mag-survey. Napakaraming data na makukuha nyo sa internet. Okay? Ngayon, kung ikaw naman gumagawa ng business plan, feasibility study, pwede ka rin gumamit ng secondary data. Okay? Now, so, kaya halimbawa ng example natin, no, gumagawa siya ng report sa oil and gas industry. So, pwede kang kumuha ng mga financial statements ng mga companies na makikita mo sa kanilang website o kaya dun sa Securities and Exchange Commission. Kasi ang SEC, yan ang repository ng lahat ng financial statements ng lahat ng corporations na registered sa Pilipinas. Okay? Now, ano ba ang advantages at disadvantages ng secondary data versus primary data? Okay, ano bang advantage ng primary data? The data collected is very specific to the problem and is definitely useful. Quality of the data collected is not doubtful and it is meaningful. It may lead to the discovery of additional data and information during its collection. Ano naman ang disadvantage ng primary data? Well, there could be potential challenges involved in the collection of primary data. Example, how will you do it? When will you do it? What kind of information do you need? And why do you need to collect them? Okay, so those are the issues. Okay, the cost involved in collection of primary data may also be high kasi gagastos ka, mag-print ka ng mga forms, magta-travel ka. Of course, pag whole day ka nagtatrabaho, nasa field work ka, eh kakain ka, no, gagastos ka. So may pang emergency money ka rin. So again, it's expensive to conduct primary data. Kaya I would prefer secondary data kasi cheaper siya. Okay? Because there is a pandemic, bawal lumabas, I encourage everyone to use secondary data instead. Hey, another disadvantage of primary data is that it needs a longer timeline. Hindi mo basta-basta siya magagawa ng mabilisan. Unlike secondary data, mabilis lang siya. Primary data, syempre, ipaprocess mo pa yan, i-edit pa yan, itetest pa yan, saka ka palang makakapag-survey. So it may take several weeks before you could even conduct an interview or a survey. Now, let's look at secondary data. What are its advantages? Yung secondary data naman, there is no issue of data collection as it is obtained by performing operations on primary data collected. So, copy and paste lang. O kaya, i-Google mo lang sa internet. Makukuha mo na yung data. The cost involved is relatively lower kasi internet lang yan eh, walang bayad. Okay? Quality of data is not the responsibility of the investigator. Okay? Kasi, obviously, pag yan ay nagamit na, it must be quality data. Now, when you talk about secondary data, ano naman ang disadvantages nito? It may not be possible that the information or data required for obtaining the secondary data is available. Okay? Second disadvantage, getting detailed and clarified data on some topic is not possible in secondary data as a limited source of information is there. Okay? And finally, the data may be unrealistic, inappropriate, or maybe it could be fake. Yeah, merong mga secondary data na fake, ha? Mag-ingat tayo dyan. Okay? Now, for video lecture number 26, this is your recitation question. I want you to state your group number and the name of your group in the comment section. Will your group be using primary data or secondary data for your research project? So, sagutin lang nyo yung tanong na yan. Primary data ba o secondary data ang gagamitin nyo? Or combination? And I want you to state the reason why are you choosing to use primary data or secondary data or both. State the reason, okay? Make sure you place your answers in the comment section of my YouTube channel below this video, okay? Within 6 days, only 6 days, ha? So take note. So, I will see you in video lecture number 27. See you around.